Okay, from that beautiful one by Olus Mabele titled Keba, we now move on to Masuwa by Jibe Mpiana. But then, we are not going to listen to this beautiful piece from the DRC in its entirety because we have to make our next stop over in Victoria, Cameroon, where actress Payang Elizo Lumwe is on standby and she's ready to join us for this beautiful radio conversation on her career and ambitions in the movies. Okay, at exactly 11:45 here in the studio of Apex One Radio, let us go to Limbe and find out if our next guest is with us. Welcome to the show, Elizo.
Thank you, Ellen.
How is Limbe today?
Limbe is great. We have very sunny weather, thank God.
Okay. So, Elizo Payang is a Cameroonian actress, and we are going to be talking about her career and her projects. Elizo, I understand that you just did Kumba Bread. Am I right?
Very right.
I was speaking with someone a while ago, and we were just saying that Kumba Bread is a very captivating movie title, which is definitely going to catch the attention of potential viewers of that movie. Has it been released yet?
Yes.
So, is it in circulation already?
Well, Kumba Bread is not in circulation yet, but it will be from the 27th of February 2016.
Okay. And so is this movie shot in Kumba, as the title suggests?
Well, it's not really as the title implies. It was shot in Limbe.
Okay. Wow. Okay.
Yes.
Right. I wouldn't bother you much to talk about the movie because that should be with its producer, but I would like to know how you came on board this movie project.
Wow. Well, actually, it's a Limbe-based chapter actors project, and I'm a member of the Nakam in the chapter.
Okay.
And we actually sort of, we are actors, we sort of doing something to keep our art strong and moving. So we have to come up with this short story, and we sort of, why not do it down and get it going. So actually that's how I came on board the project, Kumba Bread.
Okay. And
fortunately, having a director in our midst, I was tasked to be one of the cast of this show.
Right. That's some good information there. Kumba Bread is a group project run by members of the National Actors Guild of Cameroon, Limbe Branch. Okay. So, Elizo, which character are you playing in this movie, and how did you find it playing that role?
I played the friend of Sophie in the movie. Sophie is the lead actress, and I played the character of Sophie's friend.
Okay.
And
I would imagine that the cast of this movie is entirely Limbe-based actors. Am I right?
Very correct.
And so, who are some of them, and how did you interact with them in this project? What was your experience working with them?
Wow. Trust me, I love and enjoy the flow with my co-actors on Kumba Bread, especially Onyema Laura, whom I related with directly as a lead. We understood ourselves so well that even when one person missed her line, the other could easily just cover it up and flow on like there weren't any omissions. She's really a great actress, trust me, and I love to work with her over and over again. Talking about the crew, was an awesome crew, trust me.
Right. And who is the director of this movie?
The director of this movie is Mr. Edgar Leroy. He is a young director presently he's following in filmmaking in Lagos, Nigeria. But trust me, he really did a great job on the movie Kumbagwe. This was one of his, I think his third shot he was directing, and I enjoyed working with him.
Okay. And even before this movie is released, would you say that you are satisfied with your performance in it?
Well, only to an extent. Why? Because I believe if given a chance to redo, I could do better. But at the level I reached the movie is now, I'm okay with the performance I did out there on Zimbabwe.
Her name is Elizo Payang Lumye, one of the starring actresses in Kumba Bread, an upcoming Cameroonian movie that is shot and produced by the National Actors Guild of Cameroon, Limbe Branch. She is an actress par excellence, and of course, she's speaking live on Apex One Radio. The show is African Fiesta, coming to you this day, December the 9th, 2015. Back to you, Elizo. Apart from Kumba Bread, which other movies have you performed in?
I have performed in Kamas, Alma, the most just recent Alma by Eka Krista. I did feature in Nightfall by Amelie Nienbaum, Strangers, and a host of others.
Right. So, how long has Elizo been acting in movies, and what motivated you to get into this art?
Okay. I started acting in 2008. That was when the movies come out by Ndenju Nabil in Bamenda.
Okay.
And about acting, what influenced me? Actually, acting has been something I've been doing since my nursery school days. While in nursery school, doing probably nursery school graduations, I'm always involved in the school dramas, to entertain parents in graduations, in church, from the school, and the YP rallies. I am always part of drama presentation and all of that. My mom, she's a very good actress. So while I was growing up, she always loved to involve me in the church activities. But ironically, when I actually grew up and I wanted to take acting professionally, you might be surprised she really didn't want, she wasn't really in support of that. But gradually, I think she's getting to accept me.
And Elizo, there is that one movie you would always want to talk about when you are asked about your movie life. Which one is that? And which has been the most challenging, if I may put it that way?
My most challenging movie so far was the Nigerian / Cameroon production that was produced by Princeton Production. The movie Uba and Princess of Cameroon. First, the challenge I had with that movie was because I had to do something that I had never expected myself to do. I had to do, first of all, with fright. I had to do it with fright because the movie I had to ride on a horse. Some horse I've never been familiar with before. I had to get familiar and get into character at the same time on set. It was really challenging, but thank God I was able to pull it, so I am grateful.
And are you that straight-jacketed actress who would be seen just in some particular roles, or you are flexible to an extent that you would do any role?
Well, personally, I'm comfortable with any role except things or pornographic things. I'm good with them, every role, from a housemaid to the hot university girl, from everything. I think I'm comfortable with them.
Now, what makes you a good actress? I know it's difficult to assess one's self, but then you probably know your strengths.
first of all, I have a strong will, my willingness to learn more things, irrespective of what I already know, and my quest of humility. I always seek to be humble, to find that humble part of me in every domain I find myself, every body I meet, in every state I'm working on. So, to me, I think that's what has been keeping me going, and of course, God.
Right. Now, I understand that there are so many movie projects in Cameroon nowadays that every blessed day you have solicitations from left and right with scripts coming up. What would you want a script to look like for you to accept it?
First, it should be a strong story. Secondly, it should be a story that it can influence life positively. It should be a story that somebody can watch and like, okay, this thing has been doing it this way. It shouldn't have been this way, because this way is the right way and what I've been doing is wrong. It should be a movie that can answer to you. It relates to every age group, irrespective of the ethnicity, nationality, and it should have a strong plot. The kind that will keep somebody suspect and stay tuned to the end of the movie. Those are the kind of stories that I'm thrilled by.
Right. Okay, strong plot is what she likes to find in a movie script. I understand you are a member of the National Actors Guild of Cameroon. That has been confirmed with you taking part in a NACAM movie project. Elizo, how has this guild added value to your career as an actress?
To be honest, a lot of recognition, I must confess. I've gained the sort of recognition today in the Cameroon film industry as a result of my being a member of the Actors Guild, the Cameroon Actors Guild. A lot of movie projects have come my way thanks to NACAM. Even though my job doesn't really permit me to accept them all, but being a NACAM member, I was privileged to be one of those who were given medals by MCN during the Colors Art Festival, which took place sometime this year in April in Boya. And even this part, the short movie Kumbagwe that I just did, is thanks to being a member of NACAM. So in fact, NACAM has really done a great deal, and it's really doing a good deal, especially for the fact that I'm not just a NACAM member, but a registered NACAM, proud registered NACAM.
Right. So, generally speaking, what are some of the problems you face as an actress living and practicing the art in Cameroon?
First, the fact that our industry, though has done much, still has a long way to go before professional actors and actresses take it as full-time job, since there isn't a lot of returns realized from it as at the moment. So with that kind of situation, some of us are obliged to work alongside acting, and it's really a great limitation to our art as actors and actresses. Notwithstanding, on the other hand, I can't completely give up my job since it's not all around the clock.
Okay.
We will have projects coming by. So we are obliged to hold both at a time, our regular job and our profession as actors.
Right.
So we are really not easy doing these two. These are the main challenges personally.
Now, Elizo, let us look at your acting life in 5-10 years from now. Where do you hope to see it?
5-10 years from now. 5 years from now, I see myself being a great, great producer.
Okay.
And a role model as actress who could be a brand ambassador of some internationally recognized brand or something, and probably a marketing and a distributor of movies.
Right. When I spoke to one actress a few days ago, she said her role model was Solange Ijika. The other one told me she looks up to Krista Eka as her role model. And Cameroonian actors and filmmakers are beginning to be role models. You probably have one of them as yours as well.
Wow, what a coincidence. Truth, my one of my role models, Camille, role models, our very own Solange Ijika. That lady is good. I love her way of managing the film industry, her personal life, and everything that she goes along with. We also have Nigerian Motola Jolade. She's also good. I just admire them. And I look up to, especially Solange Ijika, so very much that I pray to be like her, if not better.
Okay. That's a good determination. Elizo, what's in the pipeline? Which one is your next project?
My next project, movie project, I will not be disclosing it now, but... Okay. Shortly, in about probably the next year, I will also be getting into presenting, TV presenting, with a new open TV, with Combat TV.
That's good. Okay, that's some good information for some of us, Elizo. And don't be surprised when we come looking for you again to tell us more about that other side of you. Elizo, thank you so much. But before you go away, there is definitely some producer who has been listening and would probably want to have you in their movie. How can they contact you?
Thank you very much to Mr. Kanjo. They can contact me on Facebook, Elizo Lumi, on Twitter, Elizo Lumi, on Instagram, Elizo Lumi. And I'm so available. Contact me anytime. I will be there.
She will always be available. Contact her anytime. Her name is Elizo Payang, Cameroonian actress based in Victoria. And of course, one of the starring actresses in Kumba Bread, an upcoming movie. Elizo, thank you so much.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Enes Kanjo. And thank you for this opportunity granting me the interview to be able to talk to you and tell the whole world who I actually am. Thank you very much.
I'm only physically presenting that opportunity, but it comes from God. Thank you so much, and do have a fantastic rest of the day out there in Victoria. Elizo Payang was speaking there live from Cameroon. This is African Fiesta coming to you from Apex One Radio. Let's have some music then. We turn back to our studio guest, resource person, Suleiman Koyate.